This is BayAreaSportsWeekly.com, San Francisco Giants playoff report. I'm Brian Professor B. Davis. In game number 3 of the National League Divisional Playoff Series, your San Francisco Giants came through when they had to with their backs against the wall Tuesday at the Reds' Great American Ballpark in Cincinnati. The Giants were able to prevail by a score of
2-1 in 10 innings, as these Giants are a team that scores only runs Tuesday night on a sacrifice fly sequence of a pass ball and an error. And for the Giants, who labored through a 30-pitch inning, first inning, but didn't crack, which cost two innings outings for both relievers. These are Giants who right fielder took a raw spirit to help three, as well as the bat and the glove. Giants entered game 3 on the brink of elimination, yet extended their season for at least one more day with a reviving 2-1 10-inning triumph over the Cincinnati Reds at Great American Ballpark. San Francisco's greedy performance forces a game 4 on Wednesday afternoon at Great American Ballpark. And the Giants, who surged offensively since the All-Star break to win the National League West, but were outlashed by the Reds Tuesday, collecting just 3 hits. It marked the 17th time a team won a postseason game when totaling only 3 or fewer hits. The last instance came with Houston's 3-0 win over the St. Louis Cardinals in Game 5 of the 2004 National League Championship Series. And with the score tied at 1, Giants begin the rally in the 10th with singles with Buster Posey and Hunter Pence. Jonathan Broxton, whose 5.14 ERA and 40 regular season game appearances against San Francisco, is his second worst club against any league. Giants hobbled the first with a cramp in his left calf, but was typical. Before the game, he gathered his teammates around the dugout, delivered a brief motivational talk. It wasn't so much what he said, it was the intensity and emotion, he said, with Giants right-hander Ryan Vogelsong, who called Pence address a great speech. Broxton recovered the strikeout Brandon Belt and Xavier Nady, but the right-hander first pitch to Joaquin Arias grazed Ryan Hagen's glove for a pass ball. Advancing runners, Hagen committed just 3 pass balls in 877 regular season innings. That proved crucial. Arias, facing a 1-ball, 2-strike count, tapped the grounder to third baseman veteran Scott Rowland, who bobbled the ball. When Rowland, an 8-time Gold Glove winner, quickly gathered the ball and threw the first, Arias was safe, enabling Posey to score. Incidentally, the Giants gathered their 4 runs in the series on a solo home run, a wild pitch, and a sacrifice fly and an error. Arias was racing for first and the survival in the series at stake. Sergio Romo, Giants closed many innings, retired all 6 batters he faced in the 9th and 10th inning to pick up the win. And it was a must-win game for San Francisco, as the Giants it's funny, the Giants did what they had to do. And also, Jeremy Affeldt, 2-inning stint, launched a procession of four relievers, limit the Cincinnati high-octane offense to just 1 hit in the final 5 innings. For the second consecutive game, Cincinnati starter pitched a 7-inning one-hitter. This time was Homer Bailey, who duplicated Bronson Royals. Game 2, striking out, Bailey struck out at least 1 batter, everyone but in the 3rd. San Francisco scored the first run, who allowed the benefit of a hit. Bailey and Blanco wild pitch before Brandon Crawford, Vogelsong sacrifice bunt set up, Angel Pagan's sacrifice fly. So we're going to give you the final totals of the game for your San Francisco Giants. 2 runs on 3 hits, no errors. They left 4 runners on base. For the Reds, 1 run on 4 hits with 1 error. They left 7 runners on base. The winning pitcher is Sergio Romo. The loser is Jonathan Broxton. Time of the ball game is 3 hours and 40 minutes before a sellout crowd at the Great American Ballpark in Cincinnati, 44,501. Vogelsong, the starter, did not involve in the decision. 5 innings pitched, 1 earned run, 3 hits, and 5 strikeouts. Giants had 1 hit in the first 9 innings. Scott Rowland's error was the difference for the Giants winning this ball game.
And the Reds also another boat. The Reds have now have a 7-game losing streak at home, including the 1-game playoff game, which was technically a regular season game. In that 1-game playoff, they lost to the New York Mets by back in 1999 in that National League wild card 1-game playoff sudden death game to determine who would win the National League wild card. And the Reds continue to struggle at home during the postseason. They have now lost seven overall, including that 1-game playoff they lost to the Mets back at Riverfront Stadium back in 1999. So with the win, the Giants are back in the series, 2-1. They're not out. They're long out of the They're long out of the ways to get back into it. Game four will be on Wednesday afternoon. It will be Barry Zito for San Francisco against a Red starter. We don't know who's going to start for the Reds yet. Johnny Cueto is questionable with back spasms, and we don't know who's going to be Thursday starter. But Barry Zito will be making his first postseason start as a member of the San Francisco Giants, his first overall since 2006 when he outdueled Johan Santana in Game 1 of the American League Division Series back in 2006 in the Metrodome. So the Giants will take on the Reds for game number 4. Giants need a win to force a fifth decisive game. It's still win or go home for San Francisco. Reds could win, wrap up the series with a win. The Giants need a win on Tuesday to force a game 5 on Thursday. And the first pitch for Wednesday's game will be at 1:05 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. That's 4:05 p.m. on the West Coast. Get all your Giants, latest Giants news and playoff information, go to sfgiants.com and bayareasportsweekly.com for all the Giants' latest news and so much more. This has been Bay Area Sports Weekly San Francisco Giants report on bayareasportsweekly.com, your 24-hour news service 7 days a week, 365 days a year, as your exclusive network of San Francisco Giants playoff baseball and the innovator to bring you the best sports news in the Bay Area.